Now, I've been eyeing up this chapter for quite a while because it came out about a week or two ago, but it hadn't been translated. And for reading the rules and having a look at just the design and the certain scenarios that happen within this chapter, it is very Bleach-esque when it comes to character design, when it comes to character personalities, to certain situations and scenarios that happened within Bleach. And that series is called Black Torch, and that is serialized in Jump Square. So, of course, it's a monthly magazine. I hope I'm right on that. But saying it's very much like Bleach does not mean it's a negative thing at all. Because through reading this and reading the translations, it's quite clear that it makes itself its own series and makes itself very unique, even though it takes itself kind of like a model sheet. Because it is, to me anyway, very similar to how Chapter 1 went down. Because in Chapter 1 of Bleach, what did we have? Normal kid, had a special ability, later throughout meets somebody, then at the end of the chapter gets special powers and kicks the shit out of a big monster. And this is kind of the same with this chapter. Kid with special powers, meets somebody, and then towards the end of the chapter, beats a big bad guy. And the same very much with the art style as well, is that it's very rough, but yet so mature looking. So of course, naturally, I'm interested to read this 70 page chapter. So I'll give you the quick summary. Basically, our main character named Jiro is a special case. He's a special child. He can actually hear the voices of animals. He was very much bullied as a school kid, and through growing up and becoming somewhat of a teenage or adult, so to say, like Ichigo was, he had been learning the way of the shinobi, making him quite strong. He then gets notified by some animals that there is a different kind of animal in the forest or in the woods that is injured, so he takes the animal back and looks after it, gives it a wash, and obviously this animal is not the normal kind of animal that you would see, because this is a different race. And this race is called the Mononokes. And apparently, as of right now, there's this big war going on between the two sides of Mononokes, because I'm guessing, and that's again guessing from the premise or from the dialogue that we got, is that there's one side of the Mononokes that don't eat humans and one side that do. And I guess there's like this civil war thing going on here. So because of that little conflict that they have, our main character jumps into this random battle with his sword and of course does a little bit of damage, but ultimately gets fucked. Like literally Okiora with a Sero kind of fucked. You'll understand once you read it. So our cat, which I'm now going to call Yodowichi, goes over, gives him power, and then he becomes badass as fuck and does like some One Punch Man kind of like punch to this thing. And then you got these different agencies coming or different organizations that knock him the fuck out and then want to use him for later events. So I've literally gave you the vaguest summary ever. And if you haven't noticed through reading this chapter, because there is going to be a link in the description, there's going to be a little segment now called James's new series waifu, where I spent about 10 minutes explaining why this girl is awesome and why I like her. Because one, again, you can't go wrong with booty shorts. I've said this time and time again, booty shorts are life, and she's just plain gorgeous. Again, this is fall all over again, James. You know, it's gonna get cancelled. You're not gonna be able to enjoy it. Either way, I'm stranding on too much. For a 70 page chapter, it did what it needed to do. It got you introduced to the main characters. It got introduced to some foreshadowing or some hints and mystery for future events, so it keeps you wanting to read more. It gives you a villain and how strong they can be. It gives you a good sense of power scaling. It gives you a good influence on their personalities. So I honestly don't really have anything to complain about with this chapter, because I actually overall enjoyed it and it did a good introduction for itself. And in before, the comment section down below says, oh, he doesn't have a goal like Ichigo. Look at that, James. But no, on a real, I do like the main character. He is pretty dope. He's not a dick. He's just there to help people. And that's the kind of character that I like. A confident one. Yeah, isn't a dick at the same time. He just does things because he feels like it's right. And he's very kind-hearted in that manner. Just how people in real life should be, you know, kind-hearted. I do find it funny with the samurai swords and the Yodowichi cat, and then the special powers and the very edgy teenage kind of personality to it, and the comedy going back and forth with him and his grandpa. But I like it because it gives you a sense of realism, yet a lot of surreal action as well, yet again a lot of mystery. There was, I feel like, a lot of foreshadowing within this chapter when it came to the sword that his grandpa had given him, or when it comes to the shinobi training. I want to get a little bit more on that, maybe some flashbacks. How did he become the guy that he is? Can we get some development about that? Because being a very wimpy kid and then going up to how he is now is probably the most interesting development, just like how Ichigo did when he was little and he grew up to be this angsty teen but yet strong and confident at the same time. That interested me because we actually got a really dramatic change and why he changed, and can we get that with our main character Jiro? Though by going for the fact that he's living with his grandfather, seems to me that his parents probably did die in some kind of crazy incident. And then especially some foreshadowing within the cat's mind, or I'm going to call you the witchy, there's definitely some like foreshadowing going on there. Again, the art style, again, translating through whatever the cat was thinking when it was on the floor, when it was bleeding out. There was some very interesting dialogue and some very interesting images going on within that character's mind, to which I feel is going to be very prevalent in the future. And again, makes you question, what was this? Why is this important? And why does it feel so dark and secluded? And a good job on the character designs with the villains too. If there's something with a good villain that I like, is that they've got to be intimidating and they've got to seem like a threat. And this villain, even though you can tell he's small fry from the get-go, actually did a really good job in making that impact, given a good example of what these future villains are going to be like. And overall, the dude was just savage. Again, actions speak a lot. So when this dude is literally just taking a sword to the arm and then decides to just put his nail through fucking the main character, that's kind of where I'm like, fuck. It's pretty good. But it's going to be interesting seeing a kind of samurai feel mixed in with a bit of shinobi too. So you got a bit of both worlds going on there, and seeing how our main character uses these techniques, because he has already twice within this manga. Hopefully it doesn't get overused too much, because at the start we get to see him take off his jacket, fall in one of the thugs that he was taking care of. And then towards the end of the chapter where he's fighting the main villain, where he takes off his shirt, but instead doesn't actually do nothing because he's a human and he got fucked up. And then of course, ending off the chapter with our main character on the floor with this organization literally surrounding him. But again, there's just something that I want to say about it that I really like that I can't say on camera because I just don't know what it is. And I'm hoping you guys can tell me that. It's a real big shame that this series really isn't in Shonen Jump, because this is a series that I could definitely hop on board with on a weekly basis. But then again, it would probably get cancelled like Red Sprite. So the mangaka was probably like, hey, I'm going to get a jump square. Might have a better chance there for an edgy series. I don't know. I'm just having fun with this. But again, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. What are your thoughts on Black Torch? Did it give you a bit of nostalgia or a bit of reminiscence? Is this something you'll try and keep up with? Do you guys like the art style? Do you like the story direction of where it's going? Do you like our main character's personality? I see a lot of potential in this, and I'm actually really excited to see where this actually progresses later on down the road. But of course, I am going to leave you guys with that. Tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hansen, and as always, people, peace out.